Hello Techies, in this session we will learn how to sign up and sign in for Microsoft Power Automate. It is very simple and easy to sign up and sign in for Power Automate as an individual. If you have not registered, it will take a few moments to register. Alright, let me switch to the browser and then I am going to give the URL as https://flow.microsoft.com. And then click on enter. Now over here you will find the options over here such as product, capabilities, pricing, partners, learn, support, community. Along with that, on the right hand side you will find sign in, try free, buy now options. Now to sign up or sign in into the Power Automate desktop, you need to select the option called sign in. Let's click on that. Over here you have to provide your email ID if you already registered. But over here, I'm the new user. In that case, I'm going to create a new account by clicking on create one. And then we are going to provide the email ID. I'm going to give the email ID at basha.amir86@hotmail.com. And then I'm going to click on next. And I will provide a new password to enter whenever I'm going to log in with this account. So that I will give my password over here. And then I'm going to click on next. It will ask to solve the puzzle to know you are a robot or not. So that I'm going to click on next. And then I'm going to give the respective details over here in such a way I'm going to identify or solving the problem. Now my sign up has been completed successfully. And then I'm going to give it welcome to Power Automate. I'm going to give it as United States or based on your country or region. And then I'm going to click on get started. Once you sign in successfully to Microsoft Power Automate, you will find these menus on your left hand side. One is home, action items, my flows, create, templates, connectors, data, monitor, AI builder, process advisor, solutions, and finally we can see learn. Let me explain you one by one about these. First, we'll start with create. This is the place where you start to create a new automated flows. You can create different types of flows that you can create to automate your tasks. You can create cloud flows, desktop flows, or business flows. Cloud flows can create when you want to automate to be triggered either automatically, instantly, or via schedule. Desktop flows, by using desktop flows, we can automate tasks on the web or desktop. Business process flows. Business process flows provide a guide for the people to get work done. They provide a streamlined user experience that leads people through the processes their organization has defined for interactions that need to be advanced to a conclusion of some kind. This user experience can be tailored so that people with different security roles can have an experience that best suits the work they do. All right, next one, MyFlows. MyFlows is the place where your flows resides, such as cloud flows, desktop flows, business process flows. Along with that, you will have the flows which has been shared with you. There you can see I'm having cloud flows tab, desktop flows tab, business process flows tab, and shared with me. These flows will be available whenever you have created with create option. All right, next one. Action items. Action items are the place where you can manage approvals and business process flows. There you can see I'm having two types of actions. One is approval, where you're going to receive the approvals, send the approvals, and the kind of history you can see. Another one, business process flows over here, where you can find all the active business process flows. Along with that, you can find your inactive business process flows also. Now, the next one is the templates. Templates are the place where you can look some of the most popular templates. This should give you some great ideas for flows you can, if you want to try. There you can see, I will get all the flows under the all flows. There are some featured flows, and also you can find there are some flows have been shared with you and remote workflows, and you can see approval button, video, data collection, email, events and calendars, mobile, notifications. These are the different types of templates which are very popular. There you can see, if you observe over here, one of the template like saveoutlook.com email attachments to your OneDrive. This is the one of the template which has been automated, and almost 166,000 people are using these templates across the globe. And there are some of the popular templates are available which going to be using across the organizations. All right, you will find all these templates under template tab. Next one, connectors. Formerly, these connectors were calling it as services, where you can connect from one service to another service or from one application service to another application services. There you can see I'm having popular connectors such as Office 365 Outlook, OneDrive for Business, Office 365 Users, SharePoint, Microsoft Dataverse, Twitter, Notification and whatnot. And also you can see which are the recently added connectors under this tab. There you can see Hunter, Button 1. So, and there are so many connectors are available under this connectors tab. There are two types of connectors we are having. One is standard, another one is premium connectors. Standard connectors are available with the particular account, whereas premium connectors are available based on pay-as-you-go concept. All right, all these connectors are available under this connectors tab. Now, we'll go for data. Data is the place where you can access entities, connections, custom connectors, and gateways. These are all available under data. We'll discuss about these options in the upcoming sessions. Next one, monitor. By using monitor, we can monitor all our CloudFlow's activities, desktop flow runs, machines in just one location to keep your automations running smoothly. There you can see, if you click on the CloudFlow activity, you will find over here all your activities over here for related to the CloudFlows. There you can see, you can get the notifications, you will get the failures, and you can get the all the activities. And also, if you want to see any activity which are live, there you can see, when you create a CloudFlow, this is where all you will see the alerts, runs, and notifications. You can create your blank, or else you can create a CloudFlow by using browse templates. In a such a way, we can go for the desktop flows runs, where you will get all your desktop flows over there. As of now, I don't have any desktop flows over here. So that if you want to create any desktop flow, you have to use desktop application, that is Power Automate Desktop. So whenever you're going to select, go to the desktop flows, you can create and run a desktop flows from the Power Automate Desktop. Now, we'll talk about the machines under the monitor. I have created many machines over here. There you can see, check the real-time health and status of all your machines where the desktop flows are running. So in my case, I'm having two desktops. So both are the same, but different IP spaces. So that what happening over there, the particular, I can see all the machines health status over here. And also I can get the machine groups, VM images and gateways from here. All right. Now we'll talk about the AI Builder. AI Builder is a new Microsoft Power Platform capability that enables you to add intelligence to your automated process, predict outcomes, and helps improve business performance. There I will find Explore and Models, and also with that I can get Document Automation. Now when you go for the models, there you can see by using this model options, we can build our own model and also the models which have been shared. All right. At the same time, if you want to do some kind of document automation, in that case, you are going to use the option called document automation. Document automation combines robotic process automation, RPA, and the artificial intelligence to help you extract and interpret data from the structured, unstructured documents to automate your document workflows. From here, you can receive the documents, you can extract the data, you can validate the documents, and then you're going to export the extracted data to your ERP machines. And then you can monitor the flows also over here from end to end by monitoring the application. All right. Now, we'll talk about the Process Advisor. Process Advisor feature allows you to gain a better understanding of your business process so that you can optimize them. Process Advisor offers task mining and process mining capabilities to do this. Over here, you can see you can create a new process and then show me the Process Advisor for finance. And based on that, you can see you will get the desktop flows, Power Virtual Agents, Power App, Insights, Azure DevOps, Work Tracking, and whatnot. Finally, you'll get Logic Apps with the App Insights. And you can see there are the, you can download your Power Automate Desktop, download sample data and whatnot. There's a lot of processors available over here under the Process Advisor. And then next one is the Solutions. Solution tabs will not available with your personal account. It should be organization account or enterprise account should be there. Solutions is the place where you can manage all your solutions based on your cloud flows or desktop flows. When you host your flows in a solution, they become portable, making it effortless to move them and all their components from one environment to another environment. A typical use case is for an independent software vendor to develop flows in a sandbox environment and then move these flows to the test environment. After testing, the independent software vendor would move them to the flows to the production environment. For that, clients who purchase these flows. This process is much more easier when you create your flows in a solution and then move your solutions and their components. Flows that create in a solution are known as solution-aware flows. Last but not least, learn. Learn is the place where you can find information that will help you quickly ramp up on Microsoft Power Automate. There you can see I'm having all kind of documents related to the Power Automate, such as get started with Power Automate, create cloud flows, create desktop flows for the RPA, and whatnot. You can find the solutions for ALM, use business process flows, and whatnot. All the related information for the Microsoft Power Automate will be available under Learn tab. I hope you understand the different functionalities and features of these Power Automate menu which are coming under this dashboard. Thank you for watching this Microsoft Power Automate tutorials. If you have any queries related to this concept, please post them in the comment section. I will see you in the next session. Till then, bye-bye. Have a nice day.